As a right-handed practitioner, holding the ultrasound probe in your left hand and the needle in your right hand, two primary techniques are typically used. Horizontal approach, the needle moves from right to left. Vertical approach, the needle moves away from your front towards the opposite side. Which of these insertion approaches is considered the easiest or most challenging? Here are the options. Holding the needle with the left hand, the probe with the right hand, moving horizontally from left to right. Holding the needle with the right hand, the probe with the left hand, moving horizontally from right to left. Holding the probe with the left hand, the needle with the right hand, vertically moving away from your front to the opposite side. Holding the probe with the left hand, the needle with the right hand, vertically moving from the opposite side towards your front. Certain doctors, especially right-handed, prefer holding the needle in their right hand and the ultrasound probe in their left, moving horizontally from right to left. I have experimented with my team to hold the ultrasound probe and needle in various directions and manners. Please watch the accompanying video and decide which method is the most convenient and accurate for guiding the needle to the correct injection target. Firstly, I want to clarify that the participants in this experiment are not ultrasound operators or interventionists, they are my team members. I'm deeply grateful to my staff, who are always prepared to assist me. In this exercise, I asked them to concentrate solely on managing the ultrasound probe and needle, not the ultrasound screen. We're investigating which method allows for the easiest task management and focuses the needle at the center of the ultrasound probe. Under typical circumstances, an ultrasound interventionist must simultaneously monitor the probe and the needle's direction and coordinate the needle with the ultrasound imaging screen. In this case, however, our focus is purely on probe and needle management. First, hold the needle with the right hand and the probe with the left hand, moving horizontally from right to left. Second, hold the needle with the left hand and the probe with the right hand, moving horizontally from left to right. Following this, we've captured a close-up video of the needle's movement, aligning with the ultrasound probe. The recording documents the hand and needle motion from the right lateral perspective. Unfortunately, in this instance, her right hand obscures the needle. However, we can observe this in our second volunteer. Next, we'll watch the needle entering from the far side. For a more detailed observation, I will magnify the image. You may notice that the needle appears to deviate towards the operator's side as it passes the ultrasound probe, resulting in it being off-center. Here is our second volunteer. Similarly, he will move the needle horizontally from the right to the left side. Afterward, he'll switch the needle, probe between his hands, and move from left to right. We've also closely examined the needle's movement in alignment with the ultrasound probe. This video captures the motion of the hand and needle from a right lateral point of view. He handles the needle control quite well, keeping it centered with the ultrasound probe. We cannot see the needle, so let's enlarge the image for a closer inspection. As the needle crosses the ultrasound probe, it tends to shift towards the operator's side, causing it to be off-center. Next, we'll examine the vertical approach. In this scenario, the needle either recedes from the operator toward the far side or advances from the far side toward the operator. First, we have the operator holding the probe with their left hand and the needle with their right hand. Here, the needle moves vertically, distancing itself from the operator and towards the far side. Secondly, we have the same hand orientation, probe in the left hand, needle in the right. However, The needle moves vertically from the far side to the operator's front this time. In this clip, the needle appears to be moving toward the viewer, with the needle perfectly centered. It's as though an arrow is flying directly toward you. Next, the arrow, or the needle, is sent off its course, as you can observe the instability of the moving right hand. Next, let's observe another participant's try. In this situation, the needle moves away from the operator towards the far side, and then soars back in from the far side towards the operator. Pay attention to the flawless, accurate needle movement in the subsequent video when the needle moves away from the operator. In contrast, when the needle comes in from the far side towards the operator, you'll notice the operator's hands shaking and the needle straying off its central path. Preferences can differ among individuals, influenced by their comfort level and personal technique. One crucial aspect to remember is the tendency for people to deviate medially or laterally when moving the needle from an inferior to a superior direction. Practitioners may unconsciously lean towards this deviation when guiding a needle under ultrasound. Therefore, it's essential to remain aware of your tendencies in needle movement to ensure accurate placement. Hence, I recommend determining the most suitable approach for each procedure. While you should aim for the best method, there may be times when the second best has to be employed. However, strive always to find the most effective technique. Thank you for your time and attention. I look forward to seeing you in the upcoming videos.